Today our topic of discussion is one type of token based algorithm in distributed operating system which is called Suzuki's Kasumi's algorithm. So in previous two classes we have discussed about the mutual exclusion policy in distributed algorithm. So what happened in distributed operating system when two or more processes are competing with each other for accessing a single request or accessing a critical section which is held by another process in another area network, then what happens? The distributed operating system follows basically two types of algorithm. First one is called non-token based algorithm and the second one is called token based algorithm. So the concept of in non-token based algorithm is the algorithm itself provides a timestamp value to each and every process. Those processes who are competing with each other for accessing a single request or accessing a critical section, then this non-token based algorithm provides a unique timestamp value to each and every competitor. So that was the concept of non-token based algorithm. But what happened in token based algorithm? A unique token is distributed among all the competitors. Competitor means those processes who compete with each other for accessing a single request. So what happened in token based algorithm? A unique token is distributed among all processes or among all competitors. So the first token based algorithm which is included in our syllabus is called Suzuki's Kasumi's algorithm. So let me tell you what are the features of this algorithm. The first condition or first step in Suzuki's Kasumi's algorithm is the process who are competing with each other for accessing a critical section must be connected via a single network. Either it may be LAN or it can be WAN. But they have to connect it via a single network. Then the second step is saying there is one token in the network. The owner of the token has the permission to enter the critical section. So here you can see that in the concept of token based algorithm, only one token which is distributed among all the competitors, and those processes who owns the token has the permission to enter the critical section. Then the third condition says the token will freely move from one process to another process on the demand basis. Means the process who wants to access the critical section first broadcast one request message to each and every network. Then those process who now executing the critical section see the messages and pass its token to the requester. So that is the concept. Fourth condition says if a site without a token to enter a critical section broadcast a request for token message to all other sites. So this process I have already discussed. Now what is the condition of acquiring token? See, the first condition is the process who wants to access the critical section first have to maintain a queue. Queue is nothing but it keeps the record of all transactions. then a array. The name of the array is ln, and the entities or the values of array is nothing but the process number who are accessing the token. So each and every process or each and every requesting site have to maintain two things. First of all, a queue, and then a array, which is in one dimensional in nature. So these two things, each and every requesting site who wants to access the critical section have to maintain, first of all queue, then array. And the function of this array is, it just keeps record of all transaction. Now the second thing says, token holder sends token to the requester. When it can send token to the requester? If it is not inside the critical section, otherwise sends after executing the critical section. So that is the condition of sending the token to the requester. Now the last point says, token holder can make multiple critical section access. So this is the one type of advantage of Suzuki's Kasumi's algorithm. The advantage is, a single process can access occupy critical section multiple times. So these are the condition of token passing the token. The first condition is, after finishing the critical section, one process can request for token. And when token is granted, if this condition is met or satisfied, the condition is ln. Ln is nothing but the array name, which is maintained by each and every process. If ln equals to rn, then the process can access the critical section. Token consists of a queue and ln. Ln nothing but a one dimensional array. Queue which is maintained by a requesting site. Now token holder checks if this condition is satisfied or not. The condition is, if rnj equals to lnj plus 1 or not. If this condition is satisfied, then it can transfer the token and send token to site at the head of queue. So when one process sends the token to another process, then the process number is stored on the head of queue of that process. So that is the condition when one process can occupy the token. So here you can see the example of Suzuki's Kasumi's algorithm. See very carefully. Here 5 nodes or 5 requesting sites who are competing with each other for accessing a critical section. So this is the first requesting site, which is written by RN1. RN1 means it is the requesting network number 1, and the 5 is written within the third bracket. What is the meaning of that? The meaning of that is, there are 5 competitors or 5 requesting network who are competing with each other for accessing the critical section. That is why the 5 is written in between third bracket. And here you can see the each and every requesting network or each and every requesting site maintains a one-dimensional linear array. So it is the linear array which is abbreviated by ln, and the initial value of each and every array is 0, 0, 0, 0, 5 times 0. Why it is 0? Because no process now executing the critical section. This is requesting network number 2 right hand side, that is why it is written by RN2, and within third bracket it is the number is 5. Why it is 5? Because there are 5 competitors in this area, and third one is RN3, fourth one is RN4, requesting network number 4, and the last one is requesting network number 5. And each and every requesting network maintains a linear one dimensional array, and initial value of each and every array is 0, because now no process are executing their critical section. And here you can see the requesting network number 3 is represented by double circle. Why it is double circled? Because now the token is occupied by this network, network number 3. That is why it is represented by double circled. Now here you can see it is step number 2. So what happened? After few minutes or after some time, requesting network number 1 wants the token which is occupied by requesting network number 3, because now requesting network number 1 wants to access its critical section. So at first what happened, this side means requesting network number 1 at first broadcast it requesting message to each and every network. How it can broadcast its message? Just updates its value, first value of array. Here you can see now the first value of array is 1 and the rest of the value is 0, and this message is broadcast to each and every network. So here you can see requesting network number 2 also updates its value in array. Here you can see the value of array is 1, 4 times 0. Here it is the same thing in requesting number 3. The updated value of array is 1 followed by 4 times 0. And each and every requesting side updates its array value, because this is the requesting message which is comes from requesting network number 1. That is why the first value is updated by 1. Now after seeing this requesting message, requesting network number 3 at first checks whether the resource is free or not. If the resource is free, then it sends its token to the requesting site number 1. So here you can see one dotted line which is from RN3 to RN1, means now requesting network number 3 sends one reply message to requesting network number 1. The reply message is, now you can occupy my token. And the last thing is, the condition says the process who are occupying the token must maintain a queue. So here this queue is for requesting network number 1, because the token is occupied by requesting network number 1. That is why the value of queue is 1. So it is the top and end value of this queue, because now the requesting network number 1 occupy the token. Now, the next step. So, here you can see after some time what happened. Requesting network number 2 wants to access the critical section which is occupied by requesting network number 1. So, what happened? At first, the requesting network number 2 broadcast its request message to each and every site, and the broadcast message is nothing but it updates its array value, and the updated value is 2 times 1, then 3 times 0. What is the meaning of that? The meaning of that is now requesting network number 2 wants to occupy the token which is held by requesting network number 1. That is why the updated value will be 2 times 1 and 3 times 0. And this message it broadcasts to each and every network. So each and every network can see that now requesting network number 2 wants to access the critical section which is held by requesting network number 1. So what happened? At first, requesting network number 1 see the request message which is comes from requesting network number 2 and check whether the resources is free or not. If it is free, then it sends a reply message to requesting network number 2 and sends the desired critical section and the token to requesting network number 2. And then the value of Q is updated. Now the value of Q is 2 because the token is occupied by requesting network number 2. That is why the updated value of Q is 2. Now, after some time, requesting network number 3 wants to access a critical section which is held by requesting network number 2. So what is the process? At first, the requesting network number 3 updates its array value. The value of array is nothing but 3 times 1 and 2 times 0. The meaning of that is now requesting network number 3 wants to access the resources which is held by requesting network number 2. That is the meaning of this array. So this message is broadcast to each and every network. Now each and every network know it is the time when requesting network number 2 have to release its resources or have to release its token, and it goes to the requesting network number 3, and the value of Q is 2,3. Now the updated value of Q is 2,3. The meaning of that is now requesting network number 3 are occupying the token. So that is the process by which each and every process can occupy the critical section and execute their resources. And the advantage is a single site or single process can occupy the token or execute the critical section multiple times. That is the advantage of Suzuki's customized algorithm. That is why this RN3 or requesting network number 3 occupy the token 2 times. So that is the end of our today's class. So today we have discussed about Suzuki's customized algorithm, which is token-based mutual exclusion algorithm in distributed operating system.